गाइस हाय वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू वंस अगेन वेल्कम टू द सेशंस हाय एंड हाउ आर यू ऑल कैसे हो तुम लोग जल्दी जल्दी बता दो मेरे को आई एम अगेन बैक इन फ्रंट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू विद दिस फॉर्मूला चीट शीट द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूलाज रिक्वायर्ड बाय यू गाइस फॉर एक्सेलिंग इन योर एग्जामिनेशन बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन इज कमिंग इजंट इट और अब आप लोगों के लिए बहुत जरूरी हो गया है दैट यू मस्ट कंसोलिडेट ऑल दोज थिंग्स विच यू हैव स्टडीड टिल नाउ सो कंसोलिडेटिंग One part of that consolidation is also formula writing and having all those important formulas in your bucket, which are very important for your examination purpose. So with this objective, we are here and I have brought this formula cheat sheet. So let's start this formula cheat sheet. Linear equation is today's chapter. We have already done three chapters, that is real numbers, polynomials and coordinate geometry. This is the fourth chapter. So let's start it. Okay, the first thing. Now, in the formula cheat sheet, the first thing which we are going to study about, the most basic, that we know the linear equation in two variables is of the form ax plus by plus c equals to 0, where a is the coefficient. I'll just tell you, give me a moment. Okay, so ax plus by plus c, this is a linear equation in two variable. Linear equation in two variable. And what are those two variables? They are x and y. A is the coefficient, B is the coefficient, and C is the constant. So A, B, C are the constants part. Now, next part, it says that A and B, okay, so A and B are the zero, A and B are not zeros, mind it, because if they will become zero, this linear equation will not be in the two variables. So they are simply constants. Now, moving on, the next part. So the next part says, and this is very important for all of you, although this is not a formula, but it can come in your examination. That's why I have taken this. So you all might be knowing that linear equation in two variables has infinite solution. People do have a notion, or students do have a notion, that linear equation in two variables has only one solution. But let me tell you, it is not right. So if you write two equations, say for example 2x plus 3y equals to 10, so here you will have infinite solutions. Surely, if you write one more equation, say for example 3x minus 5y equals to 8, then if I combine both the equations, then you will get one solution, that is the intersection point of both the lines. But that is a different case. If you have only one linear equation, a linear equation, surely you will have infinite solutions. Please mind it. And it should be in two variables. So if you have linear equation in one variable, it will have again one solution. What I mean to say? Say for example, if you have 4x minus 8 equals to 0. This is also a linear equation, but this linear equation is in one variable only. So here the solution, number of solutions will be one only. X is equals to 2. Okay? Fine. Graph of every linear equation is a straight line. That is a very important part. I guess all of you must be knowing that for every linear equation, it's a straight line. X equals to 0 is also called as the y-axis. Always remember, x equals to 0 means y. And y equals to 0 means x. So we also call the coordinate axes as x equals to 0 and y equals to 0. That is also the second name. Now this is an important part which you must take into consideration and you must remember this. X equals to a. X equals to a means what? X equals to constant. So x equals to constant will always be a line which will be parallel to y axis. Again, same methodology. X equals to 0 means y axis. So x equals to any constant value means parallel to y-axis. How or what it means, I'll just tell you. Say for example, if you have x equals to 2, so which type of line will it give? Come to coordinate plane, x-axis, y-axis. So x equals to 2, come on x equals to 2. So x equals to 2, let it be here. So from here, you will make a line which is parallel to y-axis. You'll make a line which is parallel to y-axis. So x equals to 2 will be parallel to y-axis. And similarly goes for y. If you have y equals to constant, say for example y equals to 2, so you will come to y equals to 2, say for example here, and from here you will have a line parallel to x-axis, like this. So parallel to x-axis. Equation of type y equals to mx represents a line passing through the origin. Now what is this? So please pay attention. Here, in this situation, the last situation which is written here, it is written that whenever you have an equation which is in two variables, x is also there, y is also there. So y equals to, let it be, m is some constant, so let it be 3x. So here in this equation, we have y term and we have x term, but we don't have any constant term. Plus or minus, nothing is there. There is only zero. So whenever you have an equation where constant term is missing, always remember this type of line will always pass through origin. Will always pass through origin. Means the graph of this type of equation will always be going like this. Like this or like this. Isn't it? So please pay attention to this, that if it is a linear equation in two variable where constant is missing, then it will be always passing through the origin. Okay. Now moving on, next part. Next part says that, every point on the graph of a linear equation in two variable is a solution of the linear equation. Moreover, every solution on the of the linear equation is a point on the graph. What it means, please pay attention. So say for example, you have a coordinate plane, x-axis, y-axis, okay, x and y. Now say for example, you have a line. Now on this line, there are infinite points lying. 1, 2, 3, 4, infinite points they are lying, okay? So all these infinite, so say for example, let the graph, equation of this line maybe, say for example, 3x plus 5y, 3x minus 5y minus 2 equals to 0. Say for example, this is the equation. So all those points which are lying on this line, let it be like 5, 1 or anything, a, b, p, q, all these points are going to satisfy this equation. All these points are going to satisfy this equation. Means these all coordinates, these all points will be the solution of this equation. That's what it means to say. I guess you all must be knowing that also, isn't it? Just for your reference, we have taken this. Now moving on. Okay, so this is again important, that says that linear equation in one variable, just now we have seen, if we have a one equation, linear equation in one variable, so one variable always means one solution. Now after this, if you have two variable, three variable, four variable, infinite variable, for all of them, the number of solutions will always be infinite, infinite, infinite. Always it will be infinite number of solutions. Please take a note of this. Okay, moving on. And let me tell you, here everywhere A, B, C, these are the constants. Constants. Okay. Fine, moving on. So this is the most important formula of this whole chapter, and this is the only chapter which is very only formula which is very important in this chapter. The three conditions. I'm writing here. The three conditions. What are these three conditions? Please take pay attention. So the three conditions are, the first condition which is given here, that lines are intersecting. Intersecting lines, and intersecting lines means unique solution. So this is the situation here. Say for example, you have x-axis and you have y-axis. Here you have drawn two lines. One line is this and one line is this. So if both the lines are intersecting at one point, so this one point will be the solution of pair of linear equations. Mind it, the chapter for this in class 10th is given as pair of linear equations. So whenever you have a pair of linear equations, it can have three situations. The first situation, that it can intersect. Second situation, that it can coincide, we'll see that. And the third situation, it can be parallel. So I'll just elaborate you here only. First situation, that they are intersecting. Second situation, that there is one line and the second line is also lying on the first line itself. So both the lines are in overlapping, coinciding on each other. This is the second situation. Or the third situation could be that the lines are parallel, that they will never meet. So these three situations we'll see. So first of all, the first situation, which is very important, which shows unique solution if there is an intersecting line. Now, the condition which we have to remember for the examination is this one, that A1 by A2 will not be equal to B1 by B2. I hope you all know that A1, A2, B1, B2, A1, B1, C1, this is the first equation, and A2x, B2y, C2, this is the second equation. So whenever we have these two equations and the ratio of the coefficients of x is not equal to the ratio of coefficients of y, then we get intersecting lines. This is the judging condition. Fine. Moving on. The next part. The next part is for coincident lines. So this is the coincident lines part, where if all the coefficients are equal, ratio, if all the ratio are equal for x coefficient also, y coefficient also, constant also, then we will have a line which will be lying on one another. So this is, both the lines will be lying on one another. Means basically, we do not have different equations, we have a same equation. I'll give you an example. Say for example, this line has a equation 2x plus 3y equals to 6. Now, if I write one more equation, say for example, 4x plus 6y equals to 12. Is there any difference between these two equations? I would say no. Why? Because if you multiply just 2 into this equation, you will get this equation. So this basically means that I have not written two different equations, rather I have written the one equation only in two different forms. And whenever you have these two situations, you get coincident lines. Okay, this type of situation. See here, a1 by a2, 2 by 4, 3 by 6, 6 by 12, all of them are equal, 1 by 2, isn't it? So this is the situation. Fine, moving on. And the last situation is this, where it says parallel lines. So for parallel lines, important part is this, that the x ratio of the coefficients of x and y, they are equal, but the constant ratio is not equal. So a1 by a2 is equals to b1 by b2 is not equals to c1 by c2. This is an important condition, and this leads to parallel lines. Parallel lines means no intersection. So if no intersection, this means no solution. Isn't it? And sorry, in the previous situation, there were the lines were lying on one another. Isn't it? So lying on one another means multiple point of intersection. All the points will be intersected only. So here we call infinite solution. Whenever coincident lines are there, in the case of coincident lines, we call it infinite solutions. Got it? Okay, cool. So if you all got it, let's move on. And the last part is nothing but the methods of solution. So I'm not explaining this. You all might be knowing elimination method, substitution method. I'll just tell you in a brief. So you all must be knowing the elimination method, and thereafter the substitution method, and thereafter the, so this is a substitution, elimination the coefficient, okay, and thereafter the, sorry for that. So this is elimination, the first was substitution, sorry for that. The first one, okay, I'm sorry, this is some misprint. This is substitution, and thereafter elimination, and thereafter elimination, and the last method is cross multiplication. Although I do not intend to discuss all these methods because they are pretty simple, you would have studied this, and in examination it never comes that solve by this method. Sometimes you might get question over cross multiplication as a 2-marker or a 3-marker, that solve this particular equation using this cross multiplication. Otherwise, in most of the times, question will appear as given as some word problem or some type of equation, and the question will be asking you just to get the values. Now whatever method you apply, that is up to you. So you can use any method, cross multiplication, elimination and substitution. Although I would suggest you not to leave this cross multiplication, because many of the students think that sir, cross multiplication toh thoda sa tough hai, toh isko chhod dete hain. Lekin aisa mat karna, because sometimes you might expect a question which is directly explicitly mentioning that solve the particular equation using cross multiplication. So don't leave this method. So that was all in this chapter. Just this much of formula. Only three formulas are important. First part, that the graph, that how you should make the graph. Second part, that the conditions on pair of linear equations, that is a1 by a2 equals to b1 by b2 equals to c1 by c2 for coincident, a1 by a2 equals to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2 for infinite, for parallel lines, no solution, and a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, that is for unique solution, second condition, and the third part is the methods, only three part, that's it. Okay, so that was all guys. See you all again in the next week in the with one another chapter of the formula cheat sheet. Till then, bye bye, take care and happy studying. If you feel any difficulty, any issue, get in touch with me over Telegram. in the group Vedantu Harshpriyam. Okay, thank you. Bye bye. See you. Good night. Bye.